2 for RTCI. Welcome back. You're listening to the English Language Program. You can join me on my Facebook page, RTCI, the English Language Program. I want to thank my 4,000 friends on Facebook. Amine Fitouri and Ahmed Hadri from TBS. Welcome to RTCI.
Thank you.
Welcome.
I'll just let you introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is Amine Fitouri. Mm-hmm. I'm 21 years old. Mm-hmm. I am an information technology major student at Tunis Business School.
You have IT at TBS?
Yes.
Really?
Yes, we are the first generation, and mm-hmm. I am honored to be the
first generation of computer.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because it's a new wave of technology we have, so mm-hmm. we are business oriented IT students.
Good. Yeah.
My name is Ahmed Hadri. I'm 21 years old. Mm-hmm. I'm a marketing manager at TBS.
Marketing manager.
Marketing major. I'm studying
major.
I will be in the future marketing manager.
Yeah, because there's a difference between marketing student or major and marketing manager. So is TBS a good school? Many students are probably listening to you. Do you think it's a good choice for students?
If they want to have a successful business career, yes. It's actually the perfect choice here in Tunisia for public institutions. Because mm-hmm. as you know, we are the first public institution who uses English as main mm-hmm. main language of courses. We are following the American curriculum program mm-hmm. for graduating. We have a four-year curriculum, mm-hmm. which will enable us to have a bachelor degree mm-hmm. in five different majors. In accounting, in finance, in business decision making, in marketing, and in information technology. Actually, the difference between Tunis Business School and other schools, I'm talking in the public institution, yeah. is that students are allowed to have a double choice, a major mm-hmm. and a minor. Actually, I am an information technology major student, mm-hmm. and I have chosen marketing as a minor. So. We are in a good shape to start up our business mm-hmm. just after we
you just need $1 million.
Yes,
we'll talk about $1 million. Ahmed Hadri.
Yes, I agree with my friend Amin. I think
you can't disagree.
No, because what he said is right. Tunis Business School is a very good opportunity for students who are willing to open up their enterprise in mm-hmm. the future. And it's a good opportunity also for students who are willing to work in the future in multinational enterprise.
Mm-hmm. You're here to talk about the Hult Prize recently. The Hult Prize recently announced that Tunis Business School has advanced to the regional finals of the 4th annual Hult Prize. We'll have to introduce this prize, and later we'll talk about the different steps.
Okay.
Yes.
So the Hult Prize is the world's largest student competition and mm-hmm. crowdsourcing platform for social good. It was recently named of the top five ideas changing the world by President Bill Clinton and Time magazine.
Mm-hmm.
So for this year, it is themed around global food security mm-hmm. and will focus on how to get safe, sufficient food to the 200 million people who live in urban slums. All over the world.
It's good. Can you do that reading? they will watch the video on YouTube. And they will see that you're reading. So can you do it without reading? I mean, Fitouri.
Yes.
You know, this morning I woke up. I was tired, and the doctor told me, "You gotta stay at home. Don't work. You need holidays." And then I spent about 30 minutes thinking, and then I said, "No, I gotta go. I have guests. I gotta go." So go ahead.
I will. Yes. Actually, Hult Prize. Yes, now become the most gathering student competition in the world.
Mm-hmm.
This year is the 4th edition.
Mm-hmm.
The idea was launched by an ex-student in the Hult International Business School in New York. It's named Ahmed Ashkar.
Mm-hmm. Tunisian student?
No.
No?
No.
American-Palestinian.
American-Palestinian student. Mm-hmm. In the Hult
They're very active students.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
In the Hult International Business School
yeah.
in New York. He came up with the idea. The prize is sponsored by the President Bill Clinton
mm-hmm.
and backed by the global the Clinton initiative. We are participating with two teams at mm-hmm. Fitouri Business School. Actually, the competition will start in March the 1st mm-hmm. in five simultaneously in five different regions: Dubai, San Francisco, Boston, Shanghai, and London. Mm-hmm. Tunis Business School is represented by two teams: one team in Dubai, and the other team in London. Mm-hmm. I belong to the team participating in Dubai. My friend Ahmed belongs to the team of London. Mm-hmm. For this year, the challenge was to build up a project of a social enterprise mm-hmm. To reduce food insecurity all around the world in both urban and rural slums. To feed about...
It sounds clear for me. You have to explain after the a short break with music. You have 3 minutes okay. and you will have to explain your project. Stay with us. Guys, I want to know more about food security challenge in urban slums.
Yeah, so each year...
I'm not your teacher, okay? Yeah. This is the question from my friends on Facebook, so go ahead.
Thank you. So each year there is a challenge that is...
Launched by
President Bill Clinton. Mm-hmm. For this year, the challenge is food security. Mm-hmm. It's very simple. Food security exists when every human being everywhere has the ability to produce or purchase sufficient or safe food. Mm-hmm. So our job, we are required to build up a social enterprise that raise food security in urban slums by 2018. Mm-hmm. So this is our job. Now we are working with
on the project.
Yes, we are working on the project. We are doing many meetings. We are asking
meetings with whom?
With the
experts. With
yes.
Tunisian
yes.
experts or foreign?
Tunisian experts.
Could you give us an idea about the people you've met?
Actually, I will talk about my team.
Yes, go ahead.
We had some meetings.
London-based team.
No, my team is Dubai.
Dubai-based team. Mm-hmm.
Yes, we had some meeting with our professors. At this level, we still have some meeting with the professor of Tunis Business School to shape our project. To
just say hi to professors at TBS.
Yes,
hi. Very good ones.
Yes, mm-hmm. especially Professor Leila Bardedi, mm-hmm. who gave up. Give us the Canva business model to help us building our business model. Mm-hmm. Actually, I want to come back to this year challenge.
Yeah.
As my friend Ahmed said, each year the Hult Prize launches its challenge. This year we have the food insecurity problem, which we are urged to solve. Mm-hmm. There are about 200 million people all around the world in urban slums who are suffering from starvation. They don't have the right access to healthy food mm-hmm. in urban zones. So our challenge is to build up a social enterprise which has a double role: solving the problem of food insecurity by 2018 mm-hmm. and gaining some profit, because it's a business oriented challenge. It's not only solving their problem, but we have to win, to have an income.
Did you go to urban slums in Tunis? Try to have an idea about food security
challenge. Actually, we don't have urban slums in Tunis.
Really? Do you believe we don't have urban slums?
Yes, we have.
What is your definition or understanding of this of urban slums in Tunisia or in the world?
Actually, in we don't have. Miserable situation. We have such zones, yes, who don't have the right to have clean water mm-hmm. and healthy food. In Tunisia, yes, we have, but the situation in other countries, especially in Africa, mm-hmm. are much more miserable.
But don't you think you could have, or you should have started your project here in Tunisia and then moved to other regions in Africa and in South America, for example?
But the challenge is... You are required to create the social enterprise for the challenge in the world in general. Mm-hmm. But after that, after coming back from London or from Dubai, we are planning to make our project real. Mm-hmm. And maybe why not we start in Tunisia.
Tell us how you will make your project yes. real. And
because
you will tell
the solution must be global.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have the right to act to think locally. Mm-hmm. No, we think globally and act locally. This is what we have learned at your business school.
This is a good slogan. We'll have a short break with music. We'll be back in about 3 minutes. You will tell us why you've chosen the Dubai or London teams. Okay. 2:22 on RTC, welcome back. You can join us on our Facebook page, RTC, the English language program. I'm expecting your comments and feedback about this new project, this Hult Prize, the next wave of social entrepreneurs. Amine Fitouri and Ahmed Hadri, could you please introduce the teams, TBS teams?
Yes.
And by the way, Sosan has joined us. Welcome, Sosan Turki.
Welcome, Adnen, thank you. Thank you for having me.
Okay. Yes, go ahead. I told you, Gary, use the mic. Okay?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, Gary, use the mic. And you can ask questions as well. Samson is our new intern.
Welcome, Sas.
Thank you.
So, could you introduce the teams, the two teams, London-based and Dubai-based team?
Yes. I belong to the Dubai team. Mm-hmm. I will start by our team captain. Mm-hmm. My friend Abdi Fajwini, he's the one who has contacted me about and suggested to me to participate in the competition.
Is he listening?
Yes, of course.
Oh, okay.
Business law course.
Yeah.
My friend Anwar Nouri, mm-hmm. my friend Mehdi Trabelsi, mm-hmm. and my friend Emeni Kasumi, mm-hmm. and me, Emin Fitouri.
Yeah, because you have to mention ladies.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
We have only one lady in each team.
In each team. Mm-hmm.
Really? Why?
By chance.
By chance.
Yes.
It's not a choice. By chance.
Good. Ahmed?
So I belong to the London team. Mm-hmm. Actually, it's a team captain. Mm-hmm. My team members are Joma Aderj, Hamza Gadria, who is always talking about compost, Nisreen Andursi, and Mahtas Belishushin. Mm-hmm. They are among the best students in our university, in TBS.
And why the choice of London or the choice of Dubai?
For me, I choose London because I had the opportunity before to go to the Middle East. Mm-hmm. So I want to go to another continent, which is Europe. Mm-hmm. Also, I felt that in London we will have the chance to compete with European universities. Because in Dubai, I think that we will compete with Middle East universities.
I see. So that's basically the difference. But you could have started in Dubai because it would have been easier for you.
Yes, I will talk about our team in Dubai. Mm-hmm. Actually, I'm not the captain, but my friend Abdatif has done the application. He has mm-hmm. chosen Dubai, and then he informed us that he made the choice. Mm-hmm. We blamed him first.
It's not democratic.
Yes. Because we had the opportunity to compete in other regions, for Shanghai, San Francisco, mm-hmm. with a high level of competition. But then we analyzed the choice and we found that we have made the best option for two things. First, the United Arab Emirates, and especially mm-hmm. Dubai, is ranked as one of the top business zones in the region.
Mm-hmm.
We will have the opportunity to contact many entrepreneurs, mm-hmm. young entrepreneurs and businessmen, and to have contacts with international enterprises who are operating in Dubai. So we'll have the opportunity to extend our experience. Mm-hmm. Secondly, we will compete with high level schools. For example, we have the Shanghai, Japan University will be participating. London Business School also will have a team participating in Dubai.
Really?
Yes. They operate everywhere.
It's a challenge.
Yes, and from Korea, from Japan, from China, we have many universities that will compete in Dubai. So the level of the competition is very high.
What are you expecting from this experience? In Dubai or in London?
Well, we'll expect a new experience, a new international experience. Mm-hmm. We'll discover new people. We will make contacts. We will make a business network from all over the world. We'll from from our participation in the trainings there and coaching, mm-hmm. we learn how to build up a social enterprise, mm-hmm. how to make a business plan, how to convince the judges, and we will surely learn from this experience.
Good. I wish you good luck, guys. Do you think you have a chance?
Yes.
Yes, of course, yes.
Really?
If you don't have self-confidence, why we will participate?
I think that when you have a good idea, innovative idea, mm-hmm. and you really believe in your idea, I think that...
Think of that you're still optimistic, because you will listen to the news and you will see that why some people are pessimistic about the situation. Okay?
Okay.
A short break with music. Two or three, 5 minutes. You're listening to the English language program. Welcome back. It's been a sad week in Tunisia, but Amine and Ahmed are still optimistic. So, guys, I want to ask you about the application procedure for Hult Prize.
Yes, I want to start by first. An announcement was posted in Tunis Business School mm-hmm. by Mr. Salah bin Abdullah Al Dean. Mm-hmm. It was sent to all TBS students, mm-hmm. and the application was open to all students. Actually, I was contacted by our team captain, my friend Abdelatif Jouini. Mm-hmm. He suggested to me to participate.
I thought you were going to talk about him second.
And I accepted. He collected our CVs. Mm-hmm. Because he is the team captain, so the application will be done by him only. Mm-hmm. We have 5 CVs, and we wrote an essay, mm-hmm. to in which we included our mission and why we are applying in Hult Prize. This is was done in last November. And they told us via Hult Prize website, hultprize.org, and the announcement was done last January, mm-hmm. during our exams, in the half of the exam period. It was about the 8th or 9th of January. Yes, we received an email of confirmation.
Mm-hmm. They were busy.
Yes, very, very busy, and we lost our concentration because we have tough exams and tough tasks to do. So we need to be very concentrated on our exams, and suddenly we had the good news. It motivated us. By chance, we have 2 teams this year from Tunis Business School. Our team and my team and Ahmed's team, yes. Mm-hmm. This is by chance, not by choice. And I will leave the floor to Ahmed to talk more about his team.
Yes, Ahmed, go ahead.
It's almost the same procedure. For me, I got an invitation from my friend Hamza Gadari to join the team. Mm-hmm. I thank Hamza Gadari for this opportunity. I became the team captain. Actually, I received the announcement email at, I think, at 11 p.m. I was reviewing my exam, and suddenly I got...
You check your email?
Yes, I check my email, yes.
You found the confirmation?
I found the confirmation. I called my mother and my father, where I'm going. I'm going to London. They said, what? Because I didn't tell them about this the challenge. Mm-hmm. So they were happy and they encouraged me. Mm-hmm.
So I want to ask you about something else, which is the participation of Ahmed Ashqar, CEO and founder of the Hult Prize, who attributes the success of the competition to the global youth revolution. Do you believe in this global youth revolution?
Yes, actually, yes.
Really?
Yes.
Because I don't.
I'm kidding. Yes, because we have to differ between 2 schools, mm-hmm. in business, the European school and the American school. I'm talking the labor market. Mm-hmm. European don't give the opportunity for young entrepreneurs or young graduated student to have key positions or to launch the big projects. Mm-hmm. However, the American school does it. They give...
That's the American spirit.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. They encourage young to participate in launching projects, in being successful young entrepreneurs. And that's where the idea of Ahmed Ashqar comes from, to give, because young students have new ideas, the world is changing every day, and youth are in the hub of the events. Mm-hmm. So they will come up with ideas better than what experienced people may have. And Tunis Business School, we are attracted by this market, the American market, mm-hmm. unlike the other Tunisian institution, which follow the French and the European system. So we are encouraged to launch our project.
Your own business.
Yes, mm-hmm. and to be successful entrepreneurs.
Ahmed Hadri, do you believe in a global youth revolution?
Yes, of course. I think that the future belongs to young people today.
It's not the case nowadays.
For example, United Nations...
I'm talking about Tunisia, yeah?
Uh-huh. Okay. For example, the United Nations and all the global institutions of the world mm-hmm. are preparing a vision for 2050, 2020, and who will make this vision real? Mm-hmm. They are the young of the young people of today. So I believe in young people to build up a new Tunisia first, a new Africa, a new Arab world, and then a new planet.
I see. So each team selected was chosen from more than 10,000 applications received, totaling over 350 colleges and universities, representing over 150 countries.
Yes.
You have been selected. We'll have a short break with music. We'll be back in about 3 minutes, and you will tell us why you've been chosen.
Okay.
Okay? Short break with music. Stay with us. بحق ترك تشوف جميل ابليكاسيون تدخل كيفاش
احنا نقط باتش اصلا جينا
ونتصور تونس مركزين معاها زي طورا
نعم
تونس مركزين معاها
مش
انا
تاوس انت حط لي فوق ما تسمع لك تاني
Some things about your one.
So the question is about what is the difference between your team and our team? America, Middle East, from
Enhanced protection operations management. عندهم غدو production operation management. Congratulations, you have been chosen to participate in the world. Yummy!
Why was that?
What do you mean?
Global volunteer network.
let's go. Ready? Roll with me by Boyz II Men. Welcome back. We're talking about the Hult Prize, Amine and Ahmed, TBS students. What's the difference between your team, European, American, and Middle Eastern teams?
Yes, I want to start by what is the difference between Tunis Business School and other institutions in Tunis. Yes, actually, it's not a joke, but
you're confident.
Yes, I'm pretty confident to say it, and I'm proud to say it, because there is
proud
a,
and
yes,
confident.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. This is our spirit.
Yes, it's my university, my college.
So, defend your.
Yes, because for the curriculum and the training. Uh-huh. In the other university, I talk about the LMD program.
Uh-huh.
This program doesn't allow students to have to shape their career or to have a large training. However, the bachelor degree will enable you to do this. So we are a leader today in Tunisia, and we are the first institution to participate in the Hult Prize, the first Tunisian institution, because the application is sent to all institutions. Engineering schools, ISETs, and all schools.
Do you believe you've been selected because you're studying in English?
Yes.
This is probably the case.
I think so.
Because we are studying business and English at the same time. Mm-hmm. Because we are more qualified than engineering or IT schools because we are studying economics, management, marketing. So mm-hmm. I think we have the chance to win more than this student. But also the students of engineering schools and IT schools are good also.
That's locally, but what about
yes.
other teams?
Yes.
You talked about London Business School, London School of Business, you talked about
Stanford.
Are you ready?
Yes, for our region, Dubai, we'll compete with Arab University, Cairo University,
mm-hmm.
And Abu Dhabi, and the American University of Abu Dhabi, and the American School of Lebanon.
Mm-hmm.
Arab, this is in Arab countries, and we will have competence. We'll compete with other schools from Japan, from China, from Korea.
Japan and China.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
The competition
good
will
luck,
be,
my friend.
Yes, we'll be furious, and we will do our best to prove that Tunisians have great ideas to change the world, because the slogan of Hult Enterprise is change the world.
So what if you have the opportunity to travel to the United States, to New York, to win and to get the $1 million? What's your project?
After that, after winning the $1 million, surely we will open up our social enterprise. We will open up our project.
You'll start your own project, your own business.
Yes.
Which business?
Social entrepreneurship.
Social entrepreneurship.
Yes.
That's
social.
Good.
Yes.
I need a clear idea, clear vision.
It was the project will be match with the challenge, an enterprise which will help people to get sufficient and clean access to water, to food, and to improve their situation. Because our mission is to break the poverty cycle of dwellers who are living in miserable condition in slums. If you know, the average income of dwellers is $2 per day.
Mm-hmm.
$2 per day he has to buy water and to buy food and to live. So our enterprise will help those people to have better conditions.
Mm-hmm.
And personally, I wish that we will win, and we will prove to the world that Tunisia has some creative ideas, creative students, young students, and we will operate in Tunisia. I mean, why not?
Ahmed, do you have the same feeling?
Yes, certainly. Our vision is to change the world. First of all, our vision is to change the life of some people in the world, poor people, hungry people. So this is our vision, and also we should hire people. We should raise employment
mm-hmm.
in Tunisia or all over the world.
You gotta start here.
Yes, of course. We start in our country.
Everything
okay.
Girl. 2:53 on RTC. Welcome back, Amine and Ahmed. Our listeners are asking about the preparation for the competition.
Yes, for us, the team participating in Dubai, the first thing we agreed on that we are a family.
Mm-hmm.
And the decision is taken by everyone. Everything is shared. No one will impose his idea.
Mm-hmm.
We started by meeting on Skype because we didn't have the opportunity to meet.
To travel.
Yes. Then we met on TBS library. Practically every day, tiring work from 6 hours of work.
Six.
And 5 hours from 9 to 9. P.M. to A.M. to about
3 P.M.
Yes,
really.
We stay at the university, yes, to work.
Ahmed,
for my team, we are actually meeting every day. Frequently, we are meeting frequently. We are making research about the previous mm-hmm. solutions to this global food security in the world.
Mm-hmm.
We are searching for inspiration from these solutions.
Mm-hmm.
We come out with many ideas, but we found out that many ideas were done before. So we are planning to make a breakthrough and to come out with an innovative idea.
What about the next step?
Get to action. Actually, we are planning to have some meeting with some officials and
yes.
some enterprise here to present our project in front
mm-hmm.
of them.
Yes.
Some we have will have
Tunisian
some,
or foreign
Tunisian and we have in our
ministers
no, I don't think so. Many professionals or entrepreneurs in Tunisian entrepreneurs.
Yes. Remaining ministers. We're still waiting for the cabinet reshuffle. Your final message to all listeners, guys.
Yes, I will personally would like to thank our dean, Mr. Salah bin Abdallah, for his report.
Mm-hmm.
All the professor and all, especially Professor Laila Baghdadi,
mm-hmm.
Professor Corina. She
mm-hmm.
She is an American professor teaching at the Tunis Business School,
mm-hmm.
and everyone who helped us during our preparation.
Mm-hmm.
And a message for our listeners on RTCE.
Yeah,
keep confident. We have innovative youth generation in Tunisia. The future will belong to us. We will do our best to make this country
better.
Yes, better.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you, Ahmed.
For me, finally, I would like first to thank RTC for this opportunity.
Thank you for coming.
Also, I would like to say
That's
to our true. Listeners that don't miss any opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to say that we are planning to honor our country
mm-hmm.
and
your school as well.
And our school is but our country because we will be the only Tunisian team which is will be in London. So I hope we honor our country and our young people.
Thank you for coming, guys. Ahmed Hadri and Amine Fitouri from TBS. Thank you very much. Those who have missed this interview, they can find the podcast and the video on my Facebook page, RTCE, the English language program. So, awesome. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
I thank Abdelkader Sonia Hadjiwi and Qaisar Bouziba for the valuable technical assistance. Next news update in French, in the German language program with Moussouf Labib. Until we meet again, I'm your host, Adnen Chaouachi. Stay tuned to the best radio in Tunisia. Stay tuned to RTCE. Bye.
Merci.
Ça va, hein?